For the reaction now from the White House, Press Secretary Sarah Sanders joins me now from the North Lawn. And Sarah, good morning to you and welcome back on what has turned out to be a rather significant Monday morning. I want to go through a number of things that I've heard from Democrats in a moment here. But first, what the president said was talked about an illegal takedown that failed. When will we hear from him today, Sarah?
You know, the president's got a number of meetings today, and we'll see if some of those open up where he decides to address the press directly. Again, he did so twice yesterday, and I wouldn't be surprised if he does that again today.
Okay, so we'll wait on that. With regard to releasing the full report, is the White House opposed to that, yes or no?
Again, as the president has said, he wants full transparency in this process. We absolutely know and have said for over 2.5 years there was no collusion. Now Bob Mueller is also saying the same thing. But that decision's up to the attorney general, and the president is leaving it up to him at this point in time.
You wouldn't object to it, though. That's what I'm hearing from your answer. Yes.
Again, we want to make sure that I think some of the biggest things that we have to look at is that we're protecting the office of the president. And it's not just about this president, but it's about the future as well, and making sure things like executive privilege and sources and methods and things like that are protected. And that's why the attorney general will look at this and make the best decision, not just for this president, but this attorney general is going to make the best decision for America. And he's going to make the best decision for the office of the president.
Okay. Did the AG Bill Barr, did he confer with the White House on his summary before it went to the Hill?
No, there was not a discussion about details and like a negotiation process of any type between the White House and the Department of Justice.
Did you see it
we
before?
Got the information about the same time that Congress received the letter the White House was
okay,
given.
So about 3:40
the notification.
About 3:40 in the afternoon on Sunday then. What is the president's reaction to this obstruction non-collusion conclusion, I should say? The obstruction thing.
Be careful. That's a tough one to say.
I get it. Yeah. What's the reaction of the president on that bottom line from Bill Barr?
The bottom line is exactly what we've said it was for 2.5 years. There was no collusion. There was no obstruction. And frankly, I think the Democrats need to be really careful here. So far, what they're doing and what they're saying, they should be embarrassed by. They have said for 2 years, they have repeatedly and breathlessly attacked the president and perpetuated this malicious lie that the president was some sort of foreign agent and working with the Russian government in order to win the election, when really all of the interference between Russia and the election took place under the Obama administration. Let's not forget that Clapper and Comey and Brennan were the ones leading the intelligence and community when these things took place, and that Obama was the president at that time. They knew about it. They did nothing about to stop it. And I think they need to be very careful about pushing too far down that
road. Is it your hunch then that the answers to everything you're raising right now will be satisfied in this Inspector General's report that could be out in May or June, 2 or 3 months from now?
I think everything should be satisfied in the report that just took place. Bob Mueller spent 2 years, as you put those numbers up earlier, 2,800 subpoenas, over 500 witnesses, millions and millions of pages of documents were given to the Mueller team, $25 million wasted in taxpayer dollars to tell us what we've been saying for 2 years. This didn't take place. There was no collusion. The president won and is sitting in the building behind me today because he was a better candidate. He had a better message. He had a better vision for our country, and he outworked his opponent. They have failed at every single step of the way to defeat this president, and they've done it again. And this time they did it at the sake of the American people by putting them through this outrageous process, by wasting their money and making this such a big part of everyday life for Democrats
Understood.
In the media,
but the next,
they should be focusing on the economy and ISIS and everything else.
The next leg in the story is why so many people chose to believe the dossier in the first place.
Because they wanted to,
Bill.
It's real simple. They wanted to. They didn't want to believe that Donald Trump had defeated them. They didn't want to believe their own failure. But this report further confirms what we all knew in November of 2016. Donald Trump won, and he won decisively, he won fairly, and he won because he was better.
But my question is, will the IG conclude that? That's what we're trying to figure out in the next leg of the story.
Why I don't know how anybody could come to any other conclusion.
To believe it. All right, another question here. You're hearing from Democrats a lot. Mueller concluded that Russia tried repeatedly to interfere with our election, but nobody took the bait. And that was one of the conclusions from the Mueller report yesterday and what Bill Barr put out. What has the administration ordered to protect the integrity of the next election 18 or so months from now, Sarah?
If you'll remember, Bill, not too long ago, we had a number of senior administration officials come to the briefing room and walk through in detail how we're taking a whole-of-government approach, DOD, DHS, DOJ, all of the intelligence community working hand in glove to make sure that what happened in 2016 doesn't continue to happen. And we're looking at and working with all of the state and local officials and making sure that we do everything we can to try to prevent this. Unlike the previous administration, we're actually taking steps to prevent this from happening again. And we're very hopeful in that process, and we're going to continue to work across the board with all of the departments and agencies to make sure it doesn't.
And when will we hear more about that, Sarah?
Again, Department of Homeland Security is one of the leads on this entire whole of government approach. I would certainly encourage you to talk to them, but I'd also encourage you to go back and look at the briefing. I think your network covered it, but a lot of networks did not on the day it took place. They spent about 30 minutes walking through in detail all of the different steps that the Trump administration is doing to protect and uphold the integrity of our elections.
Last point here. James Comey sent out a tweet yesterday. Looked like he was in a redwood forest, and his message was so many questions as he looked up in the skies above him. Lindsey Graham responded to that saying, could not agree more. See you soon. When do we hear from James Comey next, Sarah?
Look, I think that Lindsey Graham said it best. See you soon. He was one of the people that failed to do his job. He lied throughout the process. He leaked information that should never have been public. James Comey has been a disgrace to the FBI. Thankfully, this president has stepped in. He took James Comey out of that position and has been working with Director Wray to make sure we don't have similar instances. I think he's got a lot of explaining to do. And if Congress wants to call anybody up to the Hill, he should be one of the very first, followed by his friends Clapper and Brennan. And if they want to look at what really happened and what the failures of 2016 were, they need to look inside of the Obama administration, because that's where they took place.
I hope to see you soon. Sarah Sanders, thank you for your time.
From absolutely. The North Lawn today. Always great to be with you
thank
guys.
You. All right.